Right when I say that, were we going, were we speeding? Whoa, what is this guy doing? You motherfucker! Oh my God. Hello everybody, GrayStillPlays, and we're back with more of the finished Christmas simulator, no time for BS. It's a beautiful day to be alive. And the reason why I say that is because we ended up the last episode dead. But in Finland, death is not the end. It is only the beginning. I wish it was like that everywhere else. Let's go ahead and finish pissing away our worries here into the toilet bowl and check some things out. The very first thing that we have to check out is, look at this, right by the chimney. I don't think we put out any, oh, maybe he took the beer that we had over here, or maybe we just moved the beer. I wonder if Topless Gun is on this early in the morning. Oh, it sure is. Let's go ahead and put that on in the background. What do we got here? Oh, Merry Christmas. Hold on, I gotta try and read this. It says, Hiva Julia. Oh, God. I know everyone's just cringing whenever I say Finnish words in there, have you? I'm just going to headbutt this through the door. Why pick it up and put it back down and all there, have you? Let's go see what's inside. But before that, boom shakalaka. Here's another little skin that someone had made. Very cool. Got a couple of things here. Got old Gray on the side there. Got some pinstriping over here. Got the fox kind of laying over on that side. There's the YouTube banner, sponsored by YouTube. Looks like a door's almost fallen off. I don't know why, but that's probably become unbolted somehow because that's how the game works. I'll have to fix that at some point. And then the big old Datsun right here in the middle. While we're at it, another thing I guess I'll show off real quick is I think that this worked. I haven't checked it yet. There it is. There's just a little drawing someone did right there. No time for BS. I've had a lot of people ask what that means, no time for BS. It's exactly what you think it is. It's bullshit. Basically what it is, I don't know, it seems like in YouTubing, a lot of people have different intros and stuff like that, and sometimes I've seen intros that kind of like drag on and on and on. They're like, hey everybody, this is GrayStillPlays. I hope you guys are having a great day today, and make sure to follow on Twitter and subscribe. Let's try and hit 65 billion likes, and I'll be giving away a free volcano at the end of the episode to someone who finds the golden Easter egg inside of the fucking case of beer. You know what I mean? Sometimes they go on and on for a long time, so I always called that BS. So mine, mine just became, there's no time for BS, let's just fucking start playing games. So we've got a bottle of booze here, which is probably like the best present any Finnish man could get. Go ahead and put that right over there. Now, what is this booze? What exactly booze object is this? Let me get a little bit lower here. Is that a fish on the front? It is. What kind of odd, way back when I first started playing, someone said it was vodka. We have random gift money. Oh crap, phone's ringing. I wonder if it's something important. Let's go pick it up. Your post order has arrived. Wow, this is weird, isn't it, guys? Seems almost Groundhog's Day-ish. Yes, because the last time we tried to pick up the fucking post order, we died. Let's go grab our random gift money, I guess. So we're at 70, 73. What do we get? About 600 bucks. And then we get Xmas lights. Oh, you know what? Hold on. I think these go inside of the car. Yes. All right, let me get past all of this. There's my bumper laying on the ground. Oh, this freaking car. It matches my garage. You guys remember what the garage looks like? All right, let's go ahead and turn this on here. Oh, yeah. That would look sweet at night. Let me get a little look right there. It looks pretty cool, though. Not too shabby. The old Datsun mobile right there. Oh, yeah. Looks fantastic. Big fan. Let's go ahead and hop into the... Let's go ahead and hop into the van. Does this turn off or... Okay, good. I was going to say, I'm just going to leave my TV on. Anyone who would dare try and burglarize our house will be scared away by the sounds of Finnish opera in the background. Do we have anything in here? No, we don't. We got to grab items to put in this car. Very, very important. The very first thing that we're going to have to grab is a case of beer, because that should happen. Oh, look at this, guys. There's 7 beers in here, man. Only 7 beers. But 7's a lucky number. So we're gonna go ahead and grab that. We'll go ahead and grab a pack of sausages too. We're gonna be by the store anyway. So I guess if we have to buy food and stuff, we can. And well, I keep using it, and I don't know if it actually does anything, but I'm gonna keep doing it. I'm gonna use the bug spray here. Hold on, let me go ahead and break the barriers of physics real quick. In case you've never seen the barriers of physics broken. Oh, Usually there was water down there. Hold on, is this new and exciting? Let me go back into the twilight zone over here. Usually when I finish headbutt this, we find water. Oh, there it is. I knew there was water under here somewhere. Kind of going into the fifth dimension or whatever. All right, let me go ahead and close this up. Do I still hear any bugs? It seems pretty good right now. All right. Oh, I spoke too soon. I spoke too freaking soon. Anyway, I'll be back in a second when we're on our way. I've got to be fairly careful on my drive today. The reason why is because I really don't want to have to do this over again. As I talk about my great care, I go flying off the road. Recovered, though. I don't want to have to do this portion again. I want to get the new parts installed. And plus, if you remember, we still have to get the roll cage installed. Now, we bought it. We purchased the roll cage. But in order to get the roll cage done, we've got to bring the car over to Flattari's shop. And that's going to be a wee bit of a pain in the balls, because we're going to have to tow it over. And the best tower for the car is always our big rig. So I guess we'll take the big rig out. And if we can manage to suck up some shit while we're out there and do a little sewage cleaning to make a couple extra bucks, I think we're going to go ahead and do that. We can also go off the roadway. We can also... Oh, come on, man. I'm not oversteering that much. There we go. We can also do the log chopping job, which is an excellent way to make money. Big money on the log chopping job. Really looking forward to that. So, yes, I have typed up almost all of your suggestions. I'm going to get those into the developer, just things that you guys would like to see added and stuff like that, and some comments you guys had. The holiday took me, I'm doing everything at once, obviously. You know, I'm trying to do the YouTube thing and keep making videos for that. Obviously, I have a family and adultly obligations, which are very annoying. If you are a young man and you are interested in growing up and moving out of the house and becoming an adult, don't rush. Those were the best freaking days of my life. And you know, there was hardships back then, but quite honestly, being an adult is pretty annoying, especially when your plate is full as hell. But yeah, so I still had a lot of stuff I had to do. I had to cook some things, and obviously there was present getting for individuals that were deserving of presents. And then, you know, there's a get-together for the family, and I hope that you guys had a good get-together as well, a good time with your families or whatever you chose to do. If you didn't do any kind of, like, holiday thing, then I hope that the weekend just treated you good. It's kind of interesting that the Christmas this year fell on the weekend, which was kind of nice. Although, oh, mother of Jesus. Can we get the full 360? No. I was going to say, although weekend or not, it really doesn't matter for me. I work on the weekend. I work on normal days. I work all the time. So it's really nothing special. Now, while we're out here, I've got to be especially vigilant for the Green Menace. I don't know if I could call it the Thump Thump car, because I don't know if it thumps anymore. Well, what killed us last time? I don't think it was the Thump Thump car. I think it was some other dick that had to try and freaking pass a giant trucker or whatever. I think it was right at the point when I was trying to show you guys that when you get around 100 kilometers per hour, this van starts to fishtail around. Well, maybe I'll show you this time. There you go. See the rocking? Yeah, if the van's a rocking, it's not good. So don't do it. There we go. Let me go ahead and slow down there. Like I said, this is going to be a nice, calm, normal pace we're going to do here, because I want to arrive safe and sound. And when you guys drive, make sure to drive safe as well, because Gray doesn't want to see pieces of your ass all over the highway. So in the little Happy Holidays post there from the My Summer Car developer, I thought it was kind of cool. They said that they were looking for a patch in, well, they said early this year, 2017. I can't remember specifically if it said January, but it looks like it's been about one a month. So I'm really hoping for something for January. Now, a lot of people had mentioned, you know, more cars to build. Someone brought up a really good point, though, and that was that, you know, I would assume, is a pain in the ass. That is the biggest pain in the ass in the game, is making the 100 parts that the car takes to build. Because remember, I think it takes 100 parts to build the car right now that we can build, our little Satsuma. So another 100-part car may be a pain in the nuts. I mean, you know, you could say like, well, why don't you just cut and paste it? Well, honestly, I have no idea. I don't develop video games. I don't know if that's even possible or not. I would assume not, though. And plus, besides that, you wouldn't, I don't think that the people would be satisfied with a cut and paste anyway, because the whole point of building a different car is having a different experience. You want to build a different type of engine. You want to build, you know, I imagine a different type of brake system, maybe a different type of transmission or something. So, you know, in order to have fun by doing something new and exciting, you can't just cut and paste the same thing over and over again. Although, I guess if you've ever played online MMO games, that's basically what happens, isn't it? Everything's just mostly cut and pasted. At the beginning, you fight the little bunnies, and then later on in life, you fight, like, the bunnies with swords in their little paws, and then the full plate armor bunnies, and then in the end, you fight, like, the overlord bunnies and stuff like that. I joke about it, but when I was a young man, I loved MMOs. To the point was, and a lot of people often ask me, what is my favorite game? Well, I doubt you've ever heard of this game. One of my favorite games ever was a game called Dragon Realms, which was a text-based game. Actually, there was an earlier version than that called Gemstone that was one of my favorite games. That is old school. If anyone knows about that, feel free to let me know, because that is some old-ass stuff. I'll probably get an idea of how old you are by finding out whether or not you've played those games. So this douchebag is sitting over here. I don't think I'm going to finger him yet. That sounded really bad. I don't think I'm going to give him the finger yet, because I don't want him smashing up our ride. Again, survival is key. So yeah, this is a survival simulator. See? A lot of people were like, does this really simulate survival? Of course it does. I've died more times in this game than I've died in, like, legitimate normal survival games where you're trying to, like, live in the wild and stuff like that. Those survival games are one of my guilty pleasures. I love survival games a lot. And, you know, this is kind of like my first survival slash car building game. Oh, that is an interesting stack we've got going on here. I'm building the Leaning Tower of Finnish Beer. All right, let's go pay our postage and get our stuff. We've got 7,600 bucks. I think we're going to come out with about 800 bucks left when we're done here. Yep, I know. Here. Oh, we can't do it until we do this. So there we go. Okay, so you can't pick up your postage until you pay for your gas. Good to know. Now remember what happened the last time when I grabbed the sofa. I'm very hesitant on grabbing the sofa again. Not that the sofa itself does everything bad, but I'm becoming highly superstitious of the sofa. Every time I touch the sofa, I die in the game, and it makes me very unhappy. Son of a bitch! All right, well, I said to myself, maybe I can put the box in the front over here. That didn't work, so there goes the old there goes the old windshield on the fucking the van right over there. No big deal though. I mean, what do you really need it for? Let me try and throw this all the way in the back and get it as far as we can. Why does it sound like beer? Is it because it's jimmying the van, or is it like the seat in the game has the same sound effect when you're ruffling it up as beer? Some call this a broken windshield. I call it increased visibility. Oh, and you guys were mentioning too, and I'm gonna go check it out real quick. You guys were saying that the button to get the gas working isn't gone. Are we allowed to go past this guy? Wow, he doesn't give a shit at all. It's not gone, it's just moved. Right down here, look at that. So that's good to know. Because it wasn't where it used to be. I think probably because people were finished headbutting through the wall and grabbing it that way. Okay, so I'm just gonna leave this here. What do I care about a broken windshield? So can I get, now I got it in last time. All right, screw it, I'll pick it up. Oh my God, I'm setting myself up for failure. That's what I'm doing. By grabbing this sofa, I am essentially killing myself. I know I am. Every time I touch this, it's like the One Ring in the freaking Hobbit. Oh, Jesus Christ, it's already begun. It's like the One Ring, man. You think it gives you limitless power, but what actually happens is it destroys lives. Okay, how about, can we, I know the last time I had to like tilt it. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus, don't you do it. Come on, man, just sit down. Just sit on the ground. There we go. It's vibrating a little bit. I don't really know how I feel about that. It'll be fine. While we're here, I decided to fill up the old van with gas. Well, I almost said gas, diesel. Well, I guess Yeah, diesel. I took everything out of the boxes, too. The reason why is because when the stuff's out of the boxes, it's a little bit easier to manipulate. At least that's how I feel. Like, the boxes create, like, this rigid box formation. But when you have everything out of the... Well, here, let me just show you. Hold on, let me put this away. And let me remember to actually pay for the gas this time. See the seat? See how much easier the seats kind of split up? Because you can... They're out of the box. It's the same thing... Hold on, let me put the old gas cap on here, otherwise I'll forget. It's the exact same thing with the wheel and the... Come on, close up. Close for me. There we go. It's the exact same thing with the wheel and the four-point harness, which is like laying on the floorboard over there. All right, so let me pay, and I decided I'm probably going to end up getting myself killed. We're going to give old, there. We're going to give old yellow bumblebee tuna over here the middle finger. Because if I don't do it, I'm going to feel bad. Oh, let's do it over here. Hold on. Let's do it right here by this pole. Right here. Yeah, smell of shit, bitch. Oh, apparently you have to be a lot closer. All right, how about here? How about there? Oh. This is an interesting radar limitation this guy has. I don't have the energy. Well, we're gonna go. We're going through all the curses. You dork of the pussy. How about here? Whoop! Here we go. Here we go. Oh, run, run, run! Come on, dick bag. No! Oh, he almost hit our van. Whoa! Is he even aiming for us, or is he just like flipping out? I don't even know. He seems to, you know, when I feel like I drive bad, I just watch this guy. This guy spins out and gets himself stuck more than I do. And that is, there's the four-point harness. And that is saying something. Do I have to wait for this thing to warm up right now? Later, bitch you. Yes. Oh, where'd my steering wheel go? Where's the steering wheel? Oh, there it is. I was about to say, if it's just hidden underneath the beer, I don't feel too bad about it. Oh, you know what I forgot to do? I forgot to bring the hammer. I don't think that the hammer can do anything that our fists can't, because, man, our fists of finished power really mess up cars. I don't remember it being like that. I don't remember, like, pushing other people's vehicles and doing as much damage as we currently can on a push. I'll tell you what, the Finnish weather's been playing along recently here. Usually I can't get the weather to stay sunny where the crap, but today, things have been doing very well. Been pretty hot where I'm at, about 85 degrees these days, which, well, I guess that's about average. I shouldn't say it's, like, hot. Hot would probably be, like, 90 to 95 right now in the dead of winter. You know what I haven't seen in a while as well? The police. Very odd. I feel very, very cautious about that. I know the police can spawn now anywhere on the map. They always only used to be in the area, if you made a right. Shit! Right when I say that! Right when I say that, were we speeding? Whoa, what is this guy doing? You motherfucker! Oh my God. Oh my God. What was that? Why? Why did that white car try and kill us? Oh my God. All right, here I come. Hold on. I'm coming. Here we go. Throw on the old handbrake right there. Pop out of here, do our little DUI, ow, do our little DUI test, no big deal. Yes, bring it out, baby. I'll suck on it, or blow on it, either way that sounds pretty bad. Yes, look at it, looks good, doesn't it? Now wave me past, or don't, just stand there. But yeah, is that, now, was the car that killed us the last time the white car, is that some sort of suicidal car or something like that? You guys saw that, right? He was not passing anyone. That was bullshit. I don't know what was happening, but he wasn't... There was no reason for doing what he did. All right, well, they're not coming after me, so I'm guessing they didn't catch me speeding. At least I think I was speeding. I feel like we were going like 100 over. Also, what the crap was that? In the back of my mind, I was sitting there thinking about whether or not I wanted to talk about the police and not having seen them. And I was like, man, I shouldn't talk about them. I'm going to jinx myself. And then the rational part of me was like, great, you asshole. That's just superstition. It doesn't change the chances of seeing the police. Thinking that that would happen is stupid. I talk about the police and then what happens? Immediately we come across them. How about you? Are you going to try and kill me, red car? Nope. You know how to drive on the right side of the road. What do we have over here? Little blue car? Okay, good. Him and I, we're on the same page. Trying to cohabitate without killing... Ooh. Ooh. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa. I just passed my freaking off-ramp. It also got really dark outside. Holy crap, is it gonna start raining? Well, it's not raining, it's just really crappy.
Oh god! Oh.
I was almost going to talk about not having seen the green car on the back roads for a while too. You know what? This game is the most sophisticated game ever made because it can read minds. It sits there and it's like, man, Gray's thinking about how he hasn't died in a while. I know. Or it's like, Gray's thinking about how he hasn't seen the police in a while. I know. Oh, shit. All right. Hold on now. Don't get too overzealous, man. I think there was some sausage laying on the ground back there, too. Eventually, I'm going to have to snag that. I feel pretty bad. Been a while since I cracked open a beer. Might as well do one now that we've passed the old DUI checkpoint, though. Thirst is getting a little high anyway. Go ahead and toss that one back right there. We should be home in no time. And once we're home, I can gloat all I want, because there's very few things that can kill us once we're home. That would be the worst thing for this game to add. Like, something that could randomly kill you at home besides, like, lightning and stuff like that. Like, I don't know. Like, malaria or something. I don't even know if that's a thing over in Finland. Obviously, I'm assuming it's not. But I don't know. Like some random madman comes along and, like, wants to steal your car and you get into a fist fight with him. And then, like, he beats you to death or something. That would be terrible. All right, man. We're back. Go ahead and grab another real quick beer here. Another quick beer. There we go. Let's go ahead and grab all of our items. We've got, let me see if I can get it first. Get my racing harness. There we go. Go ahead and throw that over there. Got the wheel laying around over here. Now, we bought like a secondary wheel. Why is this wheel better? Like, I'm curious what this wheel does that the other wheel doesn't, because I paid good money for it. Here's our sofa. This is incredible. We managed to get here with the sofa, and we didn't die. And is this a little shit pumping job coming up here? Who knows? I paid for the gas, so it's not him. Yeah, sewage wells. Wow. Look at this. We have all the sewage jobs over in Periyarvi. So what we're probably going to do is when we use the tanker to tow our vehicle over to get the roll cage put in over here by Lopi. Or, oh god, I even had the lady say it to me. What was it? It was Lope, I think is how she say it. When we go do that, we can suck up a couple of sewage wells over there to make a couple of extra bucks to go ahead and move the rest of these freaking racing things out here. Now, I don't know what these actually do anything either. Like these racing, these racing seats. We're only going to really put one in anyway because you want to keep the weight down, right? I don't know. Maybe I will put both in to make this thing like an appropriate car. Because I don't know. I feel weird. Like, I don't ever see myself getting first place anyway. Let me take the bumper out of here so that I can put this in the right spot eventually. I'll probably still forget about it, but there we go. Wow, the bumper really slides when you throw it. All right, let's start with the seat. We'll take that off. We'll get the new seat on. Then we'll probably do the harness and the wheel. All right, so we've got 9mm screws for the wheel. Not the wheels, the freaking seat. It's been a while, too, so I kind of had to fumble around until we got this. Go ahead and take this out. Hey, that little thing there, does this work? Hold on. This little thing where you can... I was curious if you could, like, push this and make the seat recline or anything. That'd be pretty weird, though. I'm not really sure what you would do with that knowledge. There should be a hidden... Where the crap is it? I was gonna say, there should be a frickin' hidden bolt somewhere over here. All right, I guess I'll go on the other side. There she goes. Oh, yeah, these old busted-out seats here are gonna get a frickin'... Gonna get a frickin' renovation, that's for damn sure. Go ahead and bust that out. Grab it. Get rid of her. I don't know, we'll just throw her against the wall over there for right now. Now, what do we got here? Seat driver. All right. Go ahead and kind of manipulate my way through here. We'll go ahead and put it in backwards because it rarely matters. There we go. I think we put on a handbrake too when we did that. I assume it's also 9mm? I don't know, I've never messed with it. Yep, there you go. 9mm, sweet. All right, so I guess we need the roll cage on before we can install the racing harness. That's fine. We'll go ahead and put it in my really, really screwed up garage right there. So the last thing for us to do then is going to be the wheel. So we got a rally steering wheel. What kind of steering wheel did I put on then? What is this secondary wheel called? A sport steering wheel. All right. I mean, I guess, I don't know. I guess the how tight or how loose the steering is. You know what I mean? Like maybe it's more responsive or less responsive. So 10 for the old steering wheel here. I imagine the new one's going to be exactly the same. Poop. There we go. Grab that bad boy over here. Go ahead and throw it into the messed up garage. Man, I love teleporting through solid surfaces. I'll tell you what. It's much more time efficient than having to do it the old-fashioned way. Let's go ahead and head over here, and there we go. One right there. All right, looks pretty good. Nothing else to bolt on here? Nope, not at all. Okay, so the thing that we have to do now is we have to be able to tow this over to Flattari's shop so that he can put the new thing on for it, the new roll cage. That's what it is. I also want to make sure that we bought the roll cage. So many, like, weird things have happened so far in this game that I can't be 100% sure. So if I go over here, didn't I buy this? Oh, maybe I didn't. Hold on, let me go over here. There we go. So, we bought the seats, we bought the steering wheel. Oh, son of a bitch. The roll cage is extra, isn't it? Man, they nickel and dime you on everything in this game. That means that we're gonna have to make money. Son of a bitch. Alright, well that's fine. So it looks like next episode, it is gonna be a freaking money-making extravaganza. We're gonna have to take the tanker out. And we're gonna have to do a bunch of pumping jobs in this thing and fill this bitch up. Plus, if we fill it up, now that we did get the quest from Flattari about dumping shit onto the parking lot of the inspection place, maybe we'll get our 10 bottles of booze. Not that I need any more booze, but whatever. Oh, did I levitate through the door? Oh, I did. Well, the door opened of its own volition. Let me go ahead and close that. Go ahead and close this door too. And then we can do our wood chopping job. And that gives us, what did that give us last time? Like 4,200 marks or something like that? Because I'm sure the roll cage is expensive as hell. You know it is. Well, in the meantime, I think you boys know what the perfect way is to wind down the day. Since the dogs are barking and the cuckoo is clucking in there, have you? Time to grab a case of beer over here and head over into the sauna. So not only can you watch my summer car while you're peeing, but you can watch my summer car while you're in the sauna yourself if you have your own sauna. That's a kind of a weird thing, though. I don't know. I know there's a bunch of people out there that do have a sauna, but would you watch something in the sauna? It's pretty hot in there, isn't it? And humid. Is that really good for your laptop or cell phone? I don't really know. I've never really messed with it. Feel free to let me know, though. Let's go ahead and head in here and close out the day. It's going to work out pretty good, too, because we're pretty damn dirty. And this is, you know, coming back in the sauna after a long, hard day of putting shit together in my summer car. It feels nostalgic because we are at 30 episodes right now of My Summer Car, I think. I'm pretty sure. I don't know. Time flies when you're having fun, man. And not only that, I always have a lot of different series going on at once. Well, you guys know, the guys that have been with me for a while, you guys know I can't stick with one game forever. I always like to play new games and check stuff out. And if I didn't do that, would have never found my summer car. So I want to keep doing it. There's always new stuff coming out. And you know what? My summer car is one of the reasons why indie developers need to get their due. So I really appreciate the guy over there, Topless Gun, I think his name is, as the developer in the forums of Steam. So I really got to thank him for, I don't know, taking the time to put this type of game together. Because there's no doubt that he spent a lot of late nights up whooping that ass and trying to get all the parts in this game that make us feel like we want to shoot ourselves when nothing goes according to plan. Crack open another beer here. And with that, as the sun goes down in beautiful Finland, we are starting to get prepared. One more beer. We are starting to get prepared to put the final touch-ups to the car together so that we can do some rallying again and you can watch Gray come in last place. Guys, hope you're enjoying My Summer Car. Till the next time, stay foxy and much love.